Thank you, everyone. Welcome. My name is Stephanie. Obviously, I am the teacher. I am so happy to get to learn and practice baby sign language with all of you today. Baby sign language borrows from ASL, or American Sign Language, using basic vocabulary to help you communicate with your little ones and enhance their learning. So what I just did there was to incorporate signs emphasizing selected keywords. I did not sign all the words, and it's important to note that I wasn't fully using American Sign Language because you can't truly communicate in ASL and English at the same time. They each have very different syntax and grammar structures. And of course, ASL is its own rich language as part of the rich culture of the deaf community. It's important to me to honor that. But by incorporating signs for keywords you use with your little ones every day, such as milk and potty and help, for example, you can help them learn to express their needs before they can communicate orally. And of course, for a child who is already communicating orally, they can have fun learning signs while exercising their amazing sponge brains. And for older little ones who might eventually want to learn American Sign Language, this can be a great stepping stone to get them interested in future study. So we're going to practice some vocabulary. We're going to sing some songs. We're going to read some books. And I hope we have lots of fun together. We'll start with some basic vocabulary. This part of the class is the same every week. We do a little sing-song repetition of some useful everyday words. If you have not been to this class before, you'll catch on really quickly. And I have to pause just a moment to And I'm back. All right, so let us begin. Hungry, 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 hungry. Hungry, 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 hungry. Eat, eat your food. Eat, eat your food. Eat, eat your food. Eat, eat your food. Thirsty, 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 thirsty. Thirsty, 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 thirsty. So if we're thirsty, we might want to drink water, 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 water. Water, 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 water. Or we might want to drink, drink our milk, drink, drink our milk, drink, drink our milk, drink, drink our milk. And just a moment. Sometimes we might want more, more, please, more, more, please, more, more, please, more, more, please. And when we don't want it anymore, we might sign all done, finished, all done, finished, all done, finished. All done, finished. Then we have the signs for the people who are very important in our everyday lives, such as one that I did at the beginning of this class. Teacher, 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 teacher. Teacher, 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 teacher. Daddy, mommy, daddy, mommy, daddy, mommy, daddy, mommy. Grandpa, grandma, grandpa, grandma, grandpa, grandma, grandpa, grandma. This next one is a sign for nanny or babysitter or any other caretaker. And it's kind of a tricky one, so I'm going to walk you through it. First, you make peace signs. And then you put your thumbs in the middle of those peace signs. Then you cross your wrists. And then you make vertical circles. So this gives you the sign for care or careful. And then to that, we will add the person appendage, which you saw when I signed teacher. This person appendage comes in handy for many signs. So nanny, 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 nanny. Nanny, nanny, or babysitter, or any other caretaker. Here's one that I'm sure many of you have seen. Baby, 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 baby. Baby, 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 baby. And I would not want to forget about friend, 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 friend. And then there's something that we often want to say to any of these people, which is, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. The sign for I love you comes from the American Sign Language letters for I, L, and Y. I love you. Then we have more signs that are useful in everyday life, such as thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I have to tell you, Jillian, it's so exciting to actually be able to see children doing this. and Amy, I love that you're with your little one too. It's so hard to get them to pay attention. So anyhow, it's exciting to like see a child actually doing it on my screen because usually I just see the adults. another sign. Sorry, 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 sorry. And you might notice that sorry is very similar to please, which we did earlier. For sorry, you close your hands. Oh. A few more. Wait, wait, please, wait, wait, please, wait, wait, please, wait, wait, please, help, help, please, help, help, please, help, help, please, help, help, please. Like many verb signs, help is directional. So I can sign, here, I'll help you. Or can you help me? Or can you help her? Another directional verb sign is share, 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 share. Share, 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 share. Few more fun ones. Play, 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 play. This one's very useful. Potty or toilet, potty or toilet, potty or toilet. Potty, toilet. And then of course, change diaper, change diaper, change diaper, change orange diaper. And of course that comes from the old fashioned safety pins on the diapers. All right, let's move on to our first song for this week. Our first song this week is called Hugs for Daddy. It gets sung to the tune of 10 Little Indians. See it there. This one is really easy. Not many signs that you need to know to do this one. So, one little, two little, three little hugs, etc. So, obviously, we've got the numbers one, two. Now, most people sign three this way. You can totally do that. Although, if you want to be doing American Sign Language, actually use these three fingers. But it doesn't matter. Either way. Four, five. But then what do we do when we get to six? Well, in American Sign Language, we go six, seven, eight, nine. And then for 10, we wiggle our thumb. 10, 10. And then, let's see, one little, two little, three little hugs. So there are two ways that you can sign hugs in American Sign Language. One is you do the love sign, but you tap, 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 tap. So it's like love times two, or just hug yourself. So I'm gonna hug myself. A cuddly daddy hug. I love it. And then we need to know the signs for little and big. Those are really easy. Little, and you kind of show with your body language, little, and then big. Show with body language and facial expressions. And then hugs for daddy, which you saw earlier. So we'll go through this very slowly. One little, two little, three little hugs. Four little, five little, six little hugs. Seven little, eight little, nine little hugs. 10 little hugs for daddy. And then we'll do big hugs. One big, two big, three big hugs. Four big, five big, six big hugs. Seven big, eight big, nine big hugs. 10 big hugs for daddy. Yay! Good job, everybody. All right. So I'm really excited about our first book for this week. The holiday that is known as Juneteenth has been celebrated in the Black community for a very long time. This happened over 150 years ago, the day that a general arrived in Texas, even though the Emancipation Proclamation had been made over 2.5 years earlier, the news that the slaves were free did not make it to Texas for 2.5 years. There are a number of potential reasons for that. A big one being that the Confederacy still had a lot of power in that area, even after the Civil War ended with the Union having won. So anyhow, this is a beautiful book, beautifully illustrated. It's by an author and illustrator who won the Coretta Scott King Award for children's literature, although they didn't win it for this, or if they did, they did not win it by the time it was published. So, and I'm sorry, this is called All Different Now. Juneteenth, First Day of Freedom by Angela Johnson, illustrated by Evie Lewis, if anybody wants to look it up. I can get myself and the book in the frame. The words are very hard to read, so bear with me. A June morning breeze off the port blew the smell of honeysuckle past the fields, past the yard. And into our room to wake us. I really want you to be able to see these pictures because they're beautiful. Let me see if I can do that without the book falling down. Nope, I cannot. Sorry. And nobody knew as we ate a little, as we talked a little, as we headed to the fields, as the sun was rising, that soon it would all be different. Then we worked and we worked and we worked some more under the hot Texas, you take the letter X and go across and down, Texas sun. You know what, I should start just showing these illustrations closer before I turn the page. Until word spread from the port, to town, through the countryside, and into the fields. That a Union general, we trace the four lines on his shoulders, but a Union general had read from a balcony. It's a sign for balcony because you can like look out. That we were all now and forever free. And things would be all different now. I watched as my Aunt Laura sang and as she held her baby. And Mr. Jake, who some say was 100, cried quietly. And a group of people bowed their heads and whispered things to each other that I could not hear. My mama held my hands softly and looked beyond. And another breeze blew over and everything fell to a hush. But later, Papa, Mama, the aunts and uncles, and all of my cousins had an afternoon picnic. Here's your sign for picnic. Picnic by the water. Water, sorry. And my baby brother, it's like there's a hat up there, like a ball cap, hat, and then same. My baby brother crawled around on our blanket as we listened to the sound of the waves. And as more people joined us, we ate as a free people. We laughed as a free people. And we told stories as free people on into the night. What was before would be no more. And as we walked back home, the cool of the night soothed our tired feet. Sorry. That padded quietly past the shadowy fields of cotton. And in the morning, the smell of the honeysuckle will wake me again beside my sisters and brother to a time. This is the sign for era or period, a time that will be for all of us. All different now. So, the end of that book. Yay. All right. Thank you, Jillian, or Jillian's little one, for hanging in there. I know when it gets quiet, we can lose the little ones.
Thank you.
But we'll pick it up again. All right. Our next song this week is The Waves at the Beach. And this gets sung to a favorite, of course, The Wheels on the Bus. So we have four verses here. The waves at the beach go up and down, etc. So the waves, we need to know the sign for waves. And then beach, we sign, we tap water on our chin. And then we do that same waves sign, but going forward. So The waves on the beach go up and down, up and down. The waves on the beach go up and down. And then all day long, that's really easy. All day long, all day long. All right, and then the next verse, the people at the beach go swim, swim, swim. So to make a sign for people, you do the letter P, which I always think is really funny because I think it looks like a little man with a penis. Penis. Sorry, children. anyhow, and they go in circles like this. So the people at the beach, and we had the sign for beach already, so water or waves. Water waves. So the people at the beach go swim, swim, swim. We just do a little breaststroke for swim. Swim, swim, swim. Swim, swim, swim. The people at the beach go swim, swim, swim all day long. And then the crabs at the beach. This is a really fun sign. You take your crab hands and you cross them. The crabs at the beach crawl back and forth. So you take your little walking man. Crawl back and, but he's gonna crawl. Crawl back and forth, back and forth. The crabs at the beach crawl back and forth all day long. And then last but not least, the kids at the beach build sandcastles. So this is a sign for children, kids at the beach. And then build. But, you know, if you don't get your hands like that, whatever, just do something. Sandcastles. So you take your sea hands, and you can just trace the turrets of your sandcastle however you want to. Whatever you want your sandcastle to look like, that's literally the sign for castle in American Sign Language, is the tracing of the turrets. Okay, we'll go through this very, very slowly. The waves at the beach go up and down, up and down. The waves at the beach go up and down all day long. Next. The people at the beach. The people at the beach go swim, 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 swim. The people at the beach go swim, swim, swim all day long. And then the crabs is my favorite. The crabs at the beach crawl back and forth, back and forth. Back and forth, the crabs at the beach crawl back and forth all day long. And finally, the kiddos. The kids at the beach build sandcastles, sandcastles, sandcastles. The kids at the beach build sandcastles all day long. Yay! Good job, everybody. It's so fun to see you following along. All right. Our second book today is about daddies. This book is called Let's Play. I love the sign for play. Rough. Rough. So, and it's about a little boy playing rough and tumble with his daddy. These pages are going to be a problem. There they are. So, by Lynne, Jonell, illustrated by Ted Rand. Daddy sits on the couch, or rather couch, sorry. I pounce. Let's play rough, Daddy. Yikes! Daddy yells, you're as bouncy as a puppy. That's a sign for dog. You slap your hip and you snap like you're calling your puppy. Daddy, you're so silly. Can you show me your signs for silly? Silly. Puppies aren't this rough. Hey, don't pull my ears, you little monkey. Can you show me your monkey signs? Monkey. I'm not a monkey, Daddy. Monkeys aren't this scary. Well, you're a wild animal. That's for sure. Oof. Are you okay, Daddy? Dad, oh, sorry. Dad, are you okay? That's a sign for fine or okay, all right. And there's Daddy, very similar hand shape. Yes, what, Daddy? I'm really a bear. Show me your sign for bears. Bear scratching his chest. Daddy opens one eye. You may be a bear, but I'm a big, hairy monster. And you know what? Big hairy monsters do to little boy bears. They grab them and toss them. And they tickle them. Show me your tickle hands. Tickle, tickle under your chin. And they tickle them and tumble them. And eat them all up. Growl. No, no, Daddy, stop. Stop playing rough, Daddy. Okay, says Dad. We'll stop. Let's have a hug. Are you still a bear, Daddy? No, I'm not a bear anymore. I'm just your daddy, and you are my little boy. Good. But Daddy, let's play rough again. That book is all done. That's the last scene. All done. Yay. All right. So this brings us to what is always my favorite part of this class, the grown-up song accompanied with music. It's going to be, you know, something you, a song that most people would be familiar with. So this week, it's Dancing Queen by ABBA. One of my favorite songs to dance to by myself. I know you all have done it. Okay, you can see that. All right, so the chorus repeats three times. You can dance, you can jive, having the time of your life. See that girl, watch that scene, digging the Dancing Queen. The hook repeats twice, and when you get the chance. And then the pre-chorus also repeats twice. So three times, twice, twice. And then there are a few verses. And during the verses, we can just chair dance or make the sign for music or the sign for dancing. So, and of course, we won't sign all the words as usual, just selected key words. So you can dance, dance. It's one of my favorite signs, dance. You can jive, which is the same, dancing. And if you could say, you can dance, you can jive, having the time of your life. So we'll sign having, have, to have, having the time. If you want, you can sign time, or you can just skip it. Having the time of your life. So there's a sign for life. You make A hands, American Sign Language letter A. And they go up your chest, like you're growing life. See that girl, watch that scene. So see, if you can make a differentiation, you are keeping your fingers pointed in because that's more passive as you demonstrate see, whereas watch is more active. So watch. So see that girl. Here's a sign for girl. Girl. And then watch that scene. I would advise just to keep it simple and watch that scene. She is, or dig in the Dancing Queen. So we have dancing again. And then the sign for queen. This is the letter Q, but if you don't get the letter, that's fine. We take the letter Q and we trace the queen's stately sash across her chest. But even if you just get your hand going like this, show me the sash. All right. So, and then when you get the chance, when, as in like happen, when it happens, when you get the chance, there's something in your hand and you grab it. That's also the sign for, that's one of the signs for grab, but in this context, it can mean chance. So grab your chance. And when you get the chance, and then the chorus, you already know, you are the dancing queen. Young and sweet. So here's a sign for young, which is different from happy. We're going to use happy in the closing song. So this is happy, young, like this. Young and sweet. Sweet. Only 17. We do the number 7 and 1. But again, you don't have to sign all this. 17. Dancing queen. Feel the beat from the tambourine. We're just gonna tap like we have a tambourine in our hand. Feel the beat from the tambourine, that's it. So I know I've thrown a lot of words and signs at you, but we'll have fun with it. All right, you guys ready? Sign ready if you're ready. Yay! All right, I just have to cue up the music. I forgot to get it ready before class. Sorry, guys. I have to look it up in my music. There it is. I have to get a package. Be right back.
Package for you.
Yeah. Thank you for waiting, everybody. All right, here we go. So during the verses, we can find music,
looking up
or dancing, or we can just chair dance. You guys do that. This is so much fun. All right. I always close with the same song. It's called The More We Get Together. I'm sure you've heard it before. The more we get together, 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 the more we get together, the happier we'll be. Because my friends are your friends and your friends are my friends. The more we get together, the happier we'll be. Thank you, children. Thank you, parents. Thank you, grandparents. Thank you, nannies. Thank you, friends. And I hope to see all of you next Friday. Also, I just want to remind everybody that I always welcome feedback and ideas about this class because I want to make it the best that it can be. Especially if you have suggestions of like popular radio songs from, you know, any time since there's been radio. that have choruses that repeat a lot that aren't sung so fast that we can't keep up with finding it. I'm always looking for more of those. And also, if you have any ideas for how I can get the word out more, I'm happy when I teach this class for one or two or five people, but I know that it's valuable, and anyhow, I'd love to see more people joining it, because I think it's great. Obviously, I'm biased, but so why don't you guys unmute yourselves? I always mean to do that at the end, and then usually I'm like, I'm done, I gotta go. So, thank you, Rebecca. Thank you, Alec. Thank you, Amy. And are you Amy, or is your little one Amy?
I'm Amy, thank you.
And what's your little one's name? What's your little one's name, Amy?
Sophia.
Yeah, hi, Sophia. Oh, thank you for coming to my class. Thank you, Marco. Awesome. All right, guys. Well, I hope to see all of you next Friday. Thank you. Bye.